All right, folks, it's Farrah with Crowd Surfing. We ran into Holly, so we thought we'd bring her down. Have you ever been to a horse and hitch parade?
You know, I went to the 24th parade that they do downtown Salt Lake City. It was a number of years ago, so that was pretty cool. But this was my first time in Ogden horse and hitch.
Yes, it's just horses and wagons. Yes.
Apparently.
I don't know if they call horses hitches or not, but...
Wait, the horses are called hitches?
I don't know. Let's go talk to some people and find out what it's about.
All right. That's what I'm here to... I figured you wouldn't know. I would have to go talk to some people.
Let's do it then.
All right, let's do it.
Look at the little horses.
Why can't I have one?
Have one what?
Have one of the little horses.
Because you're too big for a little horse.
Ride it.
Why would you have it if you didn't ride it?
Because when it gets older, I'll ride it.
They're full grown. They don't get any bigger than that.
So?
Well, then you'd never be able to ride it.
I'll have that horse and then buy a bigger horse.
Is this supposed to be a midget horse?
Maybe it is. Look at him.
All right, we are here with Dan Musgrave, and you are the director of pretty much everything, right?
Well, Dan,
you told me, but...
So we do all the rodeo, we do all the farmer's market, we do all the amphitheater events, Ogden City Arts, helping with the Temple Open House, everything that's coming up through July and August and September.
So you don't sleep much?
No, during the summers we're up all night, and we love it.
Alrighty, I am here with...
Crowd Surfing.
And no, I'm crowd surfing. Who are you?
I'm Daryl Rector.
And you are?
Ivy LeBaron.
So, what brings you guys down to the horse parade today?
The horses.
Of course. What else?
I've been to a horse parade for a long time, so it's just time.
They have one every year.
Right.
So
it's just been busy.
So, what about you? What you like the horses? You like the little horses?
I love horses. I've always wanted to ride one.
Alrighty, I am here with
Eileen Nicholas.
Eileen and. From what I understand is you need like some kind of like a medal, like a, what do they call that? The Congressional Medal of Honor, because your husband's so hard to get along with. Is there any truth to that?
No, he's okay. He's a good guy.
Farmer's Market goes all the way through September.
Okay.
We'll have another Farmer's Market this Saturday, and it's called Farm Day in the City. Uh-huh. So the farmers bring in all their big combines and all their equipment. We'll have... calves and cows and pigs and ducks and everything, so everybody knows where their food comes from, and it's all throughout the park Saturday from 8 a.m. to 3 p.m.
You know what I think? I think you're on a tight ship because he has nothing but good things to say about you.
Oh, that's so sweet. Yeah, he's a good guy. He really is.
No, you're supposed to say he better.
He better.
So... I always do this to you. You always come with different stories. What kind of silly things does John do that he doesn't want nobody to know about?
Something silly that he does.
Maybe you can just jump on one of these as they're going by.
I don't think that would be a good idea.
It might not be, but, you know, what's worse that could happen?
I don't know.
Yeah. You fell off, but you won't. She's good.
So do you own any horses yourself, or you just come down and...
I have several relatives that have them, and just seen my colonel from the ROTC at Weber State. He's on one.
Then Wednesday is our talent in the park. We have Ulfer Creek as a bluegrass band, and then Friday we have the Pioneer Days Hoedown. So the PBX motorcycles will actually do their jumps and their flips and everything right in the street. Roger Mooney, the big rodeo voice announcer, will be here to announce all the things that are going on, the Whoopee Girls, the Rodeo Queens. And then after the hoedown, we're going to have a concert with Ty Herndon, country western star Ty Herndon, and Due West, both on the same stage Friday at 8 o'clock. So big week, and then we'll have Farmer's Market, and then we start with the rodeo.
And it all begins.
Yeah, rodeo starts
again
Saturday night, all week long.
Last time you told me about his dog, and then we talked about a certain treat that he liked.
What does he do? I can't tell you on camera what...
Oh, he does nothing. Is that what you're trying to say?
No, he does things, but I can't tell you on camera.
There he is right there. No, don't say anything.
Uh-oh. We got to be quiet if he's here.
All righty. Well, thank you for talking with me. I really appreciate
it. You're welcome.
That's the best way, because then they have to take care of them and feed them and do all the work. You just come over and ride them.
Right, and then we have some relatives out in Roy that have them. And I'm going to take her out this week to go ride one.
So you'll finally get to ride one?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
All righty, guys. Well, hey, I'll let you get back to the parade, but thank you for talking with me. I appreciate it.
Thank you so much. Appreciate it.
So now tell me what we can expect on the 24th besides a lot of fireworks and a big parade.
Okay, yeah, on the 24th, we'll start out with the breakfast in the park. So everybody come down, get your pancakes, and bring the kids and get all set up. Line the Washington Boulevard for the parade. And then the parade will go through the morning. And then that night will be the 24th of July rodeo, where we'll announce the queens and Miss Rodeo Utah and all the activities that go along with the rodeo, followed with a big fireworks show.
So the 24th, I mean, you guys take that pretty seriously up here.
Yeah, we love July, and we love the 24th and everything that goes on. So it's really exciting being in Ogden for 24th of July and July all the month. And then we're going to follow that up with the Temple Open House all through August.
No, I don't think Craig... Hey, if these guys arrest you, how do they take you to jail? They have a double saddle, or like maybe a saddle with a cage on it. That's what they need. I think it would be great if this guy could rope himself. That's what would impress me. Rope himself and his horse.
I think he should rope you.
Ready, I am here with...
Carol Earle.
And can you tell me a little bit about what you're doing down here?
I came down to see the horse parade and to listen to Glenn Russin speak.
And it looks like it's just him and a guitar. Is that all he needs?
No, that is Greg Simpson that's been playing the guitar.
Oh, is that who that was?
Yeah, Glenn Russin is the... He does a lot on history, church history.
Oh, okay. So
going to be speaking at 8.
So we're busy this year.
It's a little bit busy, to say the least. Now, I can see you're trying to keep your hat on. I heard a little story about you've got a story behind a new hat every year. Is that? What's the story there?
Well, I only wear it 1 week of the year. So every time I pull it out of the closet, it looks new to everybody. But it's the same hat.
Oh, that's it. Okay. I wanted to know. I actually was looking for a hat. I thought I might get to ride a horse. And then I just found out it was Farrell who was here.
Yeah. Yeah, we'll get you a horse. His name is Tornado. Hang on.
Oh, no.
he roped me last year, remember? Yeah, here it goes. You're going to get it. This guy's going to rope you. Better look out. You're going to rope me or Holly or both. She moved. I got to stand. I'm going to get hit in the face. It's going to hurt. Oh, see? Ah! And if he pulls really hard, then I'll fall down. That wagon doesn't have any seats. That's a bummer. Well, there's hay. Yeah, there is hay to sit on. Oh, I thought he was like in a band or something. I thought it was like a band. No, he's a speaker.
Yeah, he's a speaker. But Greg Simpson's been doing the music.
I was going to say, well, maybe if he had a band and jazzed it up a little bit, more people would come listen to him speak.
Okay. I don't mean to not say anything against him, but I've never seen him do music.
So what was?
He might be surprised.
Yeah.
He might be surprised.
So what was your favorite part of the horse parade?
The Clydesdales.
The big ones.
Yeah, and there was a couple of black horses.
I need a new hat. I had kind of a silly one, and I'm in the market for a new hat. All right, well, I'm super excited to be here. It'll be my first 24th in Ogden. I got to be here for the 4th of July, Hot Rockin' 4th,
oh,
and
yes, you're gonna love
you guys know how to party up here.
Yeah, we have a lot of activities, a lot of fun, and Ogden is the place to be through the summer.
I am not going to argue that point. Well, thanks for talking to me, Dave. I'll let you, you know, get it back to work. You're a busy man.
Okay, thanks, Holly. Thanks, Bill.
All right, I'm here with Doug Stevens. Doug, the Horse and Hitch Parade. It was a great, great parade.
I thought it was fantastic.
I'm really looking forward to the 24th here up in Ogden. Do you have any special traditions you do with your family?
Well, we'll be in the parade, so we'll have to watch it from inside the parade. But there's a lot of people who come up and enjoy the day, and there's a lot of events and entries in the parade. There's something for everyone in our July 24th Pioneer Days Parade.
Because my daughter liked the little tiny horses.
I don't know. You know what? I liked them all.
I don't like horses.
I do. I don't have one, but I like them.
But then again, horses don't like me, so it's an even trade.
Well, then they probably know you don't like them.
Probably. All right. Well, hey, thank you for talking with me. I appreciate it.
You betcha.
Well, if nothing else, they're enthusiastic. Oh, look at this guy. Hey, he's carrying his horse. What? All right, well.
I don't know what what that was about.
I don't either. He's going to make tracks over there in a minute, though. Oh, wait, here he comes. Here he comes back. I'm going to see if he'll talk to me. So, why do you have pants on the front of your horse?
A banana in disguise.
Oh, he's a banana in disguise. Alrighty, I'm here with
Preston Flowers.
And can you tell me a little bit about what you're doing down here?
Just watching the parade.
I figured with the hat, you'd be riding in the parade.
I have done, but getting too old.
It's too much work, isn't it, getting them horses ready?
It is a lot of work.
But it's a lot of fun, too, right?
It's fun, it is. It's always been a fun ride.
We have the rodeo starting on Saturday, going for 5 days, so it's jam-packed with activities.
It's going to be a lot of fun.
It is. It'll be great.
Is this your busiest time of year? Because you're on the city council, is that correct?
I am, uh-huh. This year especially is very busy for us, not only with the celebration of the pioneers, but also the opening of the temple within. And that's going to run through the month of August, and that'll be very busy for us.
Are you ready? Okay, we... Oh, dear. All right, we are here with Mark. And Mark, I have to tell you, the last time I saw you, you were talking to this guy. So, and now I see you have a badge. I just need to know what was happening.
Well, I tried to explain to him that there's a little riffraff in Ogden we were trying to clean up, and we thought he was one of them. We're still not too positive.
Well,
either.
That makes sense now. I mean, anyone with a badge talking to this guy, I would be a little worried as to what's really going on.
Well, it's, you know, believe it or not, I have zero criminal record. Nothing.
We choose not.
And well, maybe what you need to do is just get a bunch of younger people to saddle your horse up for you, get on and ride it.
Well, that's a good idea.
And then when you're done, make them take care of it afterwards.
That's a good idea.
See, stick with me. We'll go places.
All right.
Most places you probably want to go, but we'll go.
Okay, good job.
All righty. Well, thank you for talking with me.
The preparation is just overwhelming, and that's taken a lot of preparation to go ahead and get ready for these events. So.
Well, it sure is beautiful. Downtown Ogden looks absolutely incredible.
Well, we're working hard. We think we've got a great town, and it's just a pleasure to be here, and we hope everyone enjoys the festivities.
Well, thank you so much for talking to us today.
Thank you. Bye.
That was hard to swallow. Sorry.
Yeah, I feel you. So, Mark, tell us what's going on today. We just came back from the Horse and Hitch show, and what's happening now? Well, it wasn't a show. It was a parade.
A parade, yeah. Everybody's putting horses away. We get a hot dog if you participated in the parade, and yeah, fun. There's about 900 horses, I got told. We even got a little pin.
Well, that's a great pin. Let's check that out.
That's sweet. We earned it.
All right, I'm here with
Josh,
Brandy, Cassie.
And so, and are you, you're scared? Okay, well, how did you guys get roped into, oh, hey, like how I did that Pioneer Days, roped into? How did you get roped into Driven Hot Dogs?
Oh, I got roped in, so I married in to the family.
Oh,
my
man.
Dad's over the Horse and Hitch Parade.
Oh, really? And what about this guy?
Same thing. It's my dad. He's over the parade.
All right, I'm here with Brandy Mortensen, who is Miss Rodeo Utah. Is that correct?
Yes, that is correct.
And how does one become Miss Rodeo Utah? I know it is a big honor because my friend Janae was once Miss Rodeo Utah.
Yes, she was. To become Miss Rodeo Utah, we actually have a whole competition. It's almost a week long.
Oh, wow.
And it entails interviews, personality, and also your knowledge of horsemanship and rodeo. We also have horsemanship competitions. We give speeches about the state of Utah. Mm-hmm. And we answer impromptu questions just like they would at a city pageant. And we also put on a whole fashion show right in the rodeo every night. So it's a lot to it.
So now between the 4th of July and the 24th, there are so many fun things happening up in this town. You were just talking a little bit about the, what, where were you at with this guy?
The shootout.
Oh, you shot him. Now see, this is all making sense.
Janae shot him first, I think. But
but she got you instead of
yeah,
me.
She's kind of a crummy shot. But we have the shootout on Friday, the 18th. We have the hoedown. And there's concerts after that. It starts at 5 o'clock. And then next Saturday, we do another shootout in the farmer's market. So we'll be doing all that stuff all day Saturday. Yeah, there's. And then Saturday 2 is the saddle changes for the Queens. And then we have our first rodeo, the Ogden Rodeo, Saturday night. So,
well, you know what I would think? You guys ought to be doing barbecue for a Western thing here.
That would probably be good.
Hot dogs are easier.
Hot dogs are easy.
Well, I guess they're kind of barbecuing them, right? They're cooking them over the fire.
It's grilled. It's healthy.
Well, I don't know if it's healthy, but it is barbecued.
That's right.
Alrighty, guys. Well, hey, thank you for talking with me. I appreciate it.
Thank you.
You know, I worked for Reams Boot and Jeans back in the day. I lived in Provo, and they had this turtle Reams. It was kind of a classic one. And it was my first experience running into fashion for rodeos, for cowboys. I mean, that is a whole world. So tell me about that part, the fashion show. How does one win a rodeo fashion show?
Well, for fashion show, what they're looking for is someone who can be on stage and emit personality and show off the clothes to the best of their ability. Because we have wonderful clothes donated by different sponsors, so we're able to model the latest in Western fashions and also some that we come up with on our own. So the judges are looking for who looks the best up there and who gives out the most personality to sell the clothes.
Tell me your favorite part. What's your, either a memory or a tradition that you have?
Oh my gosh. You know, my favorite part of being the posse is the electric light parade. That is a kick. And there's a ton of people doing it, and that's fun. But all these parades, just seeing all the little kids and waving at them and everybody's yelling, it's pretty cool.
And what kind of horse do you have?
It's a quarter horse. She's a quarter horse, a great quarter horse. We was in the front.
A guy your size should have a full horse.
Yeah, that's all I could afford. I'm in construction, and it's quarter horse.
I understand.
But we was in the front. We got to hold the flags today, so that was an honor. That was an honor
great.
To be up front. So.
I'm here with
Don Bradshaw with Backcountry Horsemen. I'm the ride coordinator.
Grace Tofik.
And do you ride horses?
All the time.
Oh, really?
So
it's my riding partner.
So do you ride horses because you like to, or because he says, hey, get on that horse?
Because I like to.
Do you have to do all the other stuff, the feeding and the watering and all that too?
No.
Oh, see, that's why you like him so much. Maybe I'll let her do the hard part.
Yes. She needs to come out and start feeding and shoveling.
Yeah, shoveling. Then you'd be like, you know what? I don't know if I want to ride these horses or not.
Yeah.
Yep.
See, now the boots, that has to be a lot of fun, because it is not just boring old cowboy boots anymore. We got some seriously, I mean, these I'm sure are for riding, and I know, but outside of riding, we get pretty exciting these days, yeah?
Oh, yes. I can't tell you, I think I have over 30 pairs of boots.
Okay, you beat me. We need to, let my husband know, see, this is normal. Shoes, girls, boots, yeah?
Yeah, they're the same as shoes. You got to have a ton.
You have to have a lot. So what are your favorite pair? Are they pink?
No, they're actually red.
Ooh, see, that would be my second choice. Okay, very cool. So tell me your favorite part. I mean, Ogden does the 4th of July and the 24th really big. What's your favorite part or best memory tradition?
I think my favorite part is being able to go to all the city events, especially I'm looking forward to tomorrow, the Special Kids Rodeo. It's good to, I love each time you get to meet with the little kids and teach them about rodeo and be able to see them having fun with the sport.
And there was no horse poop in front of us.
See, so. That is a nice thing. Yeah.
That's cool.
Usually that's what we have Farrell doing, is cleanup prior to us coming in.
Yeah, well, Saturday, I think some of that might have been Farrell's. So.
Oh, yeah.
He was getting shot at. It.
Those guns, it was hard to tell. Are loud. Come down Saturday, let them shoot at you. They're
oh, it's a blast.
When it's coming at you.
We have tons of horses down there. Kids can ride the horses, and we sell ice-cold homemade root beer. It's a ton of fun.
And the farmer's market goes until October, September?
October, I think, October. Yeah. Like 15 to 18 weeks, depending on...
That's a good thing.
Yeah.
So, were you in the parade today?
Yeah.
And what group was you guys with? Because it seemed like there was different themes.
Backcountry Horsemen of Utah. We're the group that keeps the horse trails open, a volunteer organization, lots of volunteer hours, lots of trail time.
Well, just maintaining the trails up in the mountains so people can go up and ride. And
yep. That's the Backcountry Horsemen charter, is to keep the trails open for other riders.
Well, right on.
So tell me a little bit about the sport. What's your favorite part? Do you, the barrel racing? tell me a little bit about that.
Oh, yes. Barrels is definitely one of my favorites because it's what women participate in. Yeah. But also one of my other favorites is saddle bronc riding. I have a distant relative who is a world champion saddle bronc rider, so that has been one of my favorites.
So now you're going to have to break that down. Saddle bronco riding. What does that mean?
Saddle bronc riding is where you have a bucking horse, and they have a saddle on, a specific kind of saddle made for the saddle bronc riding.
Okay.
And the cowboy has to stay on the bucking horse for 8 seconds.
Oh, that's like the movie.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Well, so the 24th will be here for the parade, and I'm looking forward to that. It'll be my first Ogden 24th of July. I think I have to hang out with Farrell again. I don't know.
Oh, that ain't all bad. He's not that bad. You know, I don't believe the criminal thing to me. Either.
Yeah, no, we know the truth there. So, Farrell, you know, what do you got on this guy? I'll make it fair.
You know, not a lot, really. I could probably come up with a couple of things, but they'd be untruths. And I mean, look at him. Let's face it, he's a little bit bigger than me, and he's got a badge, and
Hello.
Yeah.
And I'm from Upper, so.
And he's a horrible shot.
Oh, well, you know, maybe he was just being nice.
With any luck. So you spend a whole lot of time, and do you guys have like a Facebook page or a website or anything?
BCHU.com. It'll tell you all the chapters in the state, and it'll tell you when we do rides. Everyone's welcome to come and ride with us. I do a ride every Thursday night at 5 o'clock. We just had a ride yesterday up Holbrook Canyon above the Bountiful Temple. Some of them went clear to the top. Spectacular trail.
Yeah, I bet that would be a nice clip there above the temple. I can see everything. All right, you guys. Well, hey, thank you for talking with me. I really appreciate it.
You bet. Thank you.
Okay, so you do that?
I don't, but it's one of my favorites.
Oh, okay, but you've never had to do that one.
No, I haven't, thank goodness.
Okay, I was going to say, that sounds like a really dangerous thing. But so are we going to look forward to seeing that part of the competition on the 24th for the big rodeo here?
Oh, yeah, the Cowboys will be competing in saddle bronc riding a lot, along with lots of other events.
All right, come find me and you can break it down. We'll talk some more.
Okay, sounds good.
Thanks for talking with us.
Thank you.
Well, thank you for talking to us.
Thank you.
Again,
thank you,
that was really nice. I mean, twice talking to this guy. What can we say?
I love it.
Farrell, any closing words, departing words?
He keeps hitting me in the stomach. I'm going to have to do some sit-ups. I'm all self-conscious now.
You look like you're feeling better than you was Saturday.
A lot better.
I heard about Saturday. You might have been a little tired,
yeah,
Farrell.
Yeah, little hair under the dog.
All right, boys, have a good one. Thank you. I greatly chose to lasso the crazy one.
It was you I was after.
Oh! I moved away. I was a little nervous.
You look a little wild at the end of a rope, so I thought you'd be safer for me.
Yeah. Oh, wow. That's a new thing. I've never heard that before, being next to Farrell, being the wild one.
Well, yeah. Yeah, you look a little wilder than he does.
How about that? That's a first. Farrell, did you hear that? He thought I was more wild than you.
I don't know if it's the red hair or the red lipstick, but she looks pretty wild to me.
She's out of control.
I absolutely love that about her.
This is not even true.
Alrighty, I'm here with
Chuck Sloan.
Haley Sloan.
And what is it you're doing down here?
I was riding in the Ogden Parade with Coca-Cola.
I was going to say, someone told me you're with Coca-Cola, right?
Yeah.
So do you, like, get free Coca-Colas?
No, it's the fastest barrel racers out of all the junior posses. There's one from each junior posse, and we're riding on the 23rd, right after the professional barrel racers.
Oh, at the rodeo then?
Yep.
Right on. And what is it you're doing down here?
I'm just a dad supporting, got a chance to ride in the rodeo. It was an awesome, not the rodeo, the parade today. It was awesome. A lot of fun, a lot of kids smiling.
The purple. What's I've seen a few purple shirts.
If you look around, you'll see different uniforms. It's different posses. We're with West Haven posse, so we've got about 40 youths, and I'm just a parent who supports it. It's a great program.
All right, I'm here with
Scott Armstrong.
And Scott, why'd they give you a badge, bro?
Because they're crazy.
I say, because I know you, and it's odd that you have that on.
Yeah, we just do PR for the Sheriff's Department, search and rescue, and a little bit of fun.
And then you run around and shoot people in the streets of Ogden.
Yeah, pretty much.
So how did that whole thing get started? Do you have any idea? All of a sudden you guys decided it was a good idea to ride a horse and shoot a gun.
Well, for years they did a reenactment down on 25th Street, and they used to actually hang Billy Poulter down on 25th Street with their sitchel trophy. Well, they don't let us do that anymore, so now we got to just shoot each other.
So now tell me, you were in the Horse and Hitch Parade. We got Farrell all tied up. And what happens now? What do you do outside of riding horses and roping a few things?
Oh, that's about all I do. I love to rope and chase a few gals around and just ride a few horses.
That has to be a little bit handy to be able to, you know.
It's definitely a transferable skill. Yes, for sure.
Well, that's great. Are you involved with the rodeo and all the festivities happening in the next week or so?
I'm not this year. I'll probably stop by. I used to ride bucking horses and bulls here at the rodeo, but the last 3 or 4 years I quit and just kind of rope and punch cows around the house.
Well, that sounds more safe.
Well, some days it is, some days it isn't.
I guess it's all depending on, you know, what's happening around the house that day. It can be a little crazy.
So what's the best part about having horses and riding them? I know it isn't cleaning stalls. I know that's not the best part.
Basically, just that it's like having another friend, and you can just ride whenever you want. And if it takes your mind off things, if you...
So it's kind of a break from the real world for a minute.
Yeah.
I remember it seemed like at Lagoon they used to do that, and the guys would fall off the buildings and all that. You guys had to get crazy and, like, get a scissor lift and fall.
They got to provide us something soft to fall on first.
Well, if you land on your head, I think you'll be all right.
Probably. Some near big airbag.
So, and you guys are down there every single Saturday?
No, just last Saturday and then this Saturday.
Oh, so just, yep. Oh, so we better get down there then.
Yeah.
All righty, man. Well, hey, I appreciate your time. Thank you for talking with me.
But the bucking horse thing, that's amazing to me.
Yeah, it's not too bad. Last year, they talked me into getting on one here just as an exhibition for their opening ceremonies. I got on one for them, and it was pretty fun to get back on again.
Well, good. Well, so thank you for roping up Farrell. I think I'd like to learn how to do that. It could come in handy in my job.
Oh, I wouldn't mind spending a little more time teaching you anything you want.
All right, guys, look out. I'm going to learn how to rope a few things.
Perfect.
All righty, very good. Well, hey, thank you. I appreciate it.
Nice. Oh, I think the most favorite part is with her hair on fire, going as fast as you can around barrels.
Yeah. Is that what it is? Got to whoop and...
No, my horse goes fast enough with a couple of kicks.
on her wall and on her horse trailer, it says three barrels.
Two barrels.
No, three barrels.
Three barrels, two hearts, one dream.
Oh, very nice.
That's my motto thingy.
Alrighty, three guys. Barrels, two hearts, one dream. So,
right on, guys. Well, hey, thank you for talking to me. I appreciate
it. Thank you. Have a good day.
All right, folks, that's going to do it for me. So what did you think of the horse parade?
I thought it was so much fun. And you know what? I've learned a few things. Like, I need a posse. You know, the guys with the purple shirts. And I, you know, what's it going to take for me to get a posse, Farrell?
I think you have to get a horse first.
Oh, well.
So talk to your husband. Get some land. Get a horse.
Get some land? I got to have land?
Well, where are you going to put the horse? You think a dog leaves a mess in the living room? Imagine what a horse would leave.
Yeah, that might be tough. Well, maybe my friend Janae or Bill or someone. You guys got a horse I could have, right? So I could have a posse?
Oh, yeah. There you go. We'll talk to our friend Janae. She gave me a truck.
She gave you a truck?
And you know what I did with it? What
did you do?
I wrecked it.
Yeah. Of course you did. Of course you did. Okay. Well, so I learned about posses. I learned about horses and hitches. How about you? What did you learn?
Nothing.
Exactly.
I didn't learn a thing.
But it was really fun, and this is just the start. We got a lot more stuff coming up. We got a parade on the 24th.
Yep. And a rodeo from the 19th to the 24th.
That's a big deal.
It is.
Yeah, I'm excited.
Me too. Maybe we'll see if we can see Roger Mooney and talk to him.
Okay.
Roger Mooney, the rodeo announcer, the world famous rodeo announcer.
Okay. Yeah, let's find him.
All righty, we'll do it. All righty, folks. Thanks for watching.